Hello everyone and welcome to a new video. In this video I will be showing you the rock paper scissors machine that I built. If you for some reason want to make this very simple game more complicated than it needs to be, you can use this contraption to play it. You do need two features for this that are exclusive to the mod OpenRCT2, which is linked in the description. The first one is the option to test unfinished tracks and the second one is the disable clearance checks cheat. When that cheat is enabled, the game doesn't check if there's already something in the place where you want to build, allowing you to build things inside other things. This is how I made the switch tracks and also how I built tracks above each other with only a single unit of clearance. Now that that's out of the way, let's get to the machine itself. I'll first show you how to play it and then I'll show you how it works. Playing rock, paper, scissors consists of two stages. The first one is choosing which element to pick, which you do right here. The elements each have a different color. Rock is green, paper is red, and scissors is blue. The two players are light and dark versions of the colors that the elements have. First, we will let the dark players select their element. Simply right-click on the black piece that corresponds to the element of your choice, delete the track piece, and rebuild it. The color will change into the color of the chosen element. In this round, the dark player has chosen paper. Now we rotate the screen so that the light player cannot see what the dark player has chosen. The light player can now select their element in the same way. In this round, light has chosen rock. Now all we have to do is click on the station and test the right. The second element of the game is determining the winner, which is done here. You can see three tracks, each with a word next to it. Light, draw and dark. If the train comes above ground on the light track, the light player has won. If it comes above ground on the dark track, the dark player has won. And if it comes above ground at the draw track, it is a draw. Since dark selected paper and light selected rock, we would expect the dark player to win, which is exactly what we see. Now all you have to do to reset the machine is to double close the right and delete and rebuild the track pieces of the elements that were chosen. Let's do another round. This time both players select scissors, which means we should get a draw. I'll speed this up a bit so that we don't have to wait, as the machine isn't very fast. As you can see, we indeed get a result that it's a draw. Now that we have seen it in action, let's get into how it works. First, we need to get the trains from the same track onto two different tracks. You cannot use trains from two different coasters, as they will go through each other instead of colliding. For that, I have created this contraption, which I call a train splitter. The first train just barely makes the hill, causing it to go so slow that the time difference between the trains isn't long enough for them to be more than a train length apart. This causes the second train to bump into the first train, causing the second train to go backwards and take the switch track. Now that the trains are on different tracks, we can move on to the element picking part of the machine. This is done by building two of the exact same track piece on the same tile. One of the track pieces connects to the straight section ahead, while the other one connects to the turn. The train will take the track piece that is below the other one, which is determined by the order you build them in. The bottom track piece is also the visible one, which is the black one. If you delete the black track piece and rebuild it, you build it on top of the color track piece, causing the order to switch, which causes the track piece to switch color and the train to take the exit instead of go straight ahead. Since there are three options for each player, there are nine different combinations of elements. This means we need nine different points at which the trains can interact. These points are the hills you can see here. I'll show you what happens when we select rock for the light player and scissors for the dark player. The train for the light player will follow a track to the light green set of hills and start oscillating between them until it has reached the point where it meets the dark blue track. The train for the dark player then comes in at a high speed, causing it to crash into the first train, pushing it over the hill. After that, the train follows a simple track to the correct result, which is light in this case. This is the same method that I used for the calculator, if you remember that video, only on a much smaller scale. That is pretty much all there is to it. This machine is pretty useless, but I think it's cool nonetheless. If you want to play with it, the save file is in the description, but do keep in mind that you need OpenRCT2 for it to work. Thank you all for watching and I will see you in the next video.